Over the last 6 months, music video has become the most celebrated phenomenon in the world of entertainment. In the Toronto market, there are now several television shows available that program video music, including NBC's Friday Night Videos and Video Singles. In the clubs, 24-hour music video is now available on MTV, off satellite from the US. But video music is not new to Canadians. There is already a remarkable music service originating in Toronto. It all started 6 years ago when City TV made a major commitment to popular music programming at 99 Queen Street East.
Doing it right on the wrong side of Queen.
Now, when anybody, including CBC's The Journal, need to know what's happening, they come to City TV to document the success of five unique and original Canadian music shows, each with its own distinct style and point to make. The unique thing about City TV Chum FM simulcasts is that they are not a one-shot experiment or curiosity, but are a systematic series of one-hour concert specials. Out of 44 concerts, 33 have featured Canadian artists. It began with the first ever live simulcast broadcast of Murray McLaughlin from the Elma Combo.
Whispering rain, careless emotion.
Musicians have long recognized the City TV simulcasts as a means to national exposure, with state-of-the-art pictures and stereo audio. The unique thing about Chum 30 is that it is a countdown of the top singles of the week. It combines a traditional hot radio format with new music video. The unique thing about Toronto Rocks is that it is live and interactive. It is a daily journal for rock fans, providing videos, plus gossip, concert information, and high school events. The unique thing about The New Music is that it was the granddaddy of them all, and from the very beginning has insisted on illuminating a video clip with a piece of video journalism. It deals with rock sensibilities as well as music.
City TV brings you The New Music with J.D. Roberts and Jeannie Becker. Covering the big events in rock and roll. Featuring new video from around the world. Taking you backstage with the stars and bringing you the music in stereo simulcast specials. Canada's award-winning video magazine. It's all there every week on The New Music with J.D. Roberts and Jeannie Becker. Saturday nights at 10:30. See it on City.
The New Music magazine proves Toronto-based programming can find acceptance in the rest of the country. It is shown in 18 markets nationally. Over 500,000 people see music from City TV each week because over the last 6 years, The New Music has taken Canadians to major music events across Canada and around the world. When Canadian band Triumph played to 300,000 people at the second US Festival in San Bernardino, California, The New Music was there. When Canadian reggae stars Leroy Sibbles and Carlene Davis performed at Reggae Sunsplash in Jamaica, The New Music was there. As we were when Ronnie Hawkins returned to his roots in Memphis and paid homage to his old friend, Elvis Presley. It's this kind of total coverage that has resulted in one major American trade publication describing The New Music as the best music show this side of the Atlantic. But The New Music is a Canadian program, and the emphasis has been on Canadian events. The New Music has presented everything from the evolution of music in Vancouver to a major talent search in Quebec. From the world's first New Wave Festival in Bowmanville to the New Wave's Triumph, a Canadian national tour by the Police. From the largest country and western carnival ever brought to Canada, to the farewell concert of supergroup The Who, which we simulcast live across the country. While the international music community sees The New Music as the primary vehicle for exposure in Canada, the priority of the program is to celebrate Canadian musicians, and it has provided coverage of the UNOS, the Canadian Black Music Awards, and the JUNOS each year. At the JUNOS, The New Music has been recognized as a major contributor to the Canadian record industry. And in fact, last year, hosts Jeannie Becker and J.D. Roberts were on hand to present Best Group of the Year. Perhaps the real reason The New Music has established its preeminence in music programming over the last 6 years is the goodwill it has enjoyed from the music community in its home base of Toronto. It is the only television show that could bring together the entire spectrum of the music industry for an anniversary party. One of the strengths of our ties with the artists involved lies in a feeling of mutual discovery. We have introduced many new bands by producing our own videos for them, long before they came to the attention of the record companies. The television industry has celebrated our innovations into popular music programming by awarding us 14 CanPro Awards and an Iris Award for the best independently produced magazine show in North America. Finally, there is City Limits, where we bring it all together. The concert presentations of the simulcasts, the countdown of the Chum 30, the interaction and useful local information of Toronto Rocks, and above all, the journalism of the new music. City Limits is more than just video clips laid end to end. So far, City Limits runs 10 hours overnights on weekends, but with little extra effort, it could form the nucleus of a Canadian music service programmed for a national audience. With swift regulatory approval, much music could go out nationally by satellite almost immediately.